Sakura Days Japan Fair presents Tea Ceremony Demonstration by Urasenke Tankokai, Vancouver Association.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the Urasenke Tea Demonstration. Please enjoy the process of tea making. The first thing the guests do when entering the tea room is to look at the kakemono. It's either a hanging scroll, calligraphy, or painting. They are hung in accordance with the purpose of the tea ceremony. Today's calligraphy reads, Onozuto tenkara fuku kitaru. Fortune will come naturally from heaven. This is handwritten by Ho Unsei, Dr. Sen Soshitsu, the 15th generation head of Urasenke. The flower we have today is a seasonal flower. I picked fresh from the garden and arranged very naturally as it blooms in the field. We have Ms. Sumako Kakiuchi as a guest today, and host Ms. Tomoko Peters will be making tea. There are many different ways of performing tea ceremony, and today's style is called ryurei, which means standing bow style. Tea ceremony, or chado, is integration of art and culture, so we train our senses of art and mental attitude. The host purifies the utensils with square silk cloth. By doing this, host is also purifying her mind and spirit. She just purified the tea container. And the next, she is purifying the tea scoop. She purifies everything on the shelf. It is already clean, but she's purifying them all. Now she opened the hot water iron kettle. The pattern on the hot water kettle is called Toyama Arare, means hail in the faraway mountain, made by Jimon. She is now purifying the tea whisk. Now, host picks up the tea scoop and offers sweets to the guest by saying, Okashi o dozo. sweets are offered at the best timing, so the sweetness balances and mellows the bitterness of tea. She's putting the powdered tea into the bowl. Matcha is a powdered tea harvested in May, then steamed, put in cool place, then ground into powder. She just opened the cold water container. This was made by local artists. The prints on the container is birds are rejoicing spring. We have two types of matcha tea making, thick tea and thin tea. We are making thin tea today. It is for more casual occasion. It is briskly whisked, so the surface is frothy. The other tea is called the thick tea, which is kneaded with a whisk until it is blended smooth. The tea is ready to be served. Guest takes a sweets now. Today's sweets is kingyokkan. Ingredients used are gelling agent called kanten or agar agar, water and sugar. We name this sweet scenery of spring and cherry blossom. Now tea bowl is now placed onto the guest with front side of the bowl facing the guest. Front side usually has design or print. We chose cherry blossom design. She places a bowl in left hand palm and place right hand over it. Raise a little to express your gratitude. Guest turns a bowl and drinks from the other side. This is a gesture of respect and modesty. And she turns it back to original position. One of the duties for the guests is to appreciate the utensils because they have been carefully chosen in honor of the guest. There's a saying in the tea ceremony, one meeting, one opportunity. This means this particular combination of utensils and everything in this place will never be repeated. This philosophy will be carried throughout one's life. We must value each moment and make the most of each day because you may never experience the same again. Guest said, please conclude the preparation. Host responds, I will conclude now. Tea has been originally imported from China and has long history, having passed through the various historical developments. The tea ceremony was finalized in its current form by Senno Rikyu, a tea expert from the 16th century. In addition, the spirit of the tea ceremony is based on Zen concepts. Senno Rikyu explained the rules of the tea ceremony in the form of four principles, Wake Seijaku. If you keep them in mind, it will help you to understand more deeply about tea ceremony. Wa means harmony, feeling of oneness of nature and people. Everything should flow together. Host is now concluding the tea ceremony. Today we will not pass around the utensils for viewing. We will finish with total decoration of shelf unit. When the bowl is rinsed and wiped, that's a sign of no viewing. She's finishing with purifying the tea scoop. She refills the hot water kettle with the cold water. So this will conclude the whole procedure. The tea container we have today, it's called Natsume, a lacquer art, sprinkled with silver powder over it. The title of this piece is called Hako. Ha means wave, ko means light, image of glistening light of waves. This was created by Mitsuhiro Ishiguro. The tea scoop, we call chashaku, it's a carved bamboo. Honorific name given is chitose, carved by Korin. Thank you very much for watching, and we hope one day we will be able to offer you a bowl of tea. See you again. ありがとうございました。それでは皆さん、ごきげんよう。